Hey everyone, the name is Erik Thor, and today we will be taking an empath test. And I should say that this is not an empathy quest. This has nothing to do with EQ. It just has to do with one of many processes of how you relate to other people, how you feel emotions and how you deal with and process emotions. And I made this video piecing out trends that I noticed in descriptions of empaths. Trends that tend to paint the empath as the person that puts the collective interests about the individual interests. Trends that tend to put the empath as a person who just knows what's right and wrong, rather than a person who learns what's right and wrong through observation and logic. And an empath has, one, an innate understanding of nature, and two, an experience of emotions as something universal. This means that first, an empath has a natural knowledge of how people and the universe works. An empath just knows how you feel. An empath just knows how the universe works and how nature operates. They have a basic, innate understanding of the world that can be either true or false. And yeah, the most important thing of all, if you are an empath, you will just know that you are. You don't need any further study, you don't need any checklists to determine if you are an empath, you just are. An empath has a natural ability to read and understand emotions, facial expressions, subtle social nuances and expressions, clocks, mechanics, nature, biology, all of it. An understanding that doesn't require exercise or any formal knowledge. And the empath experiences emotions as something universal, as something collective. They see emotions as unique to all of us, shared with all of us, that there is no my emotions and your emotions, your values and my values. We all share a collective humanity, a collective essence. We all share a certain quality that is held by all of us, encompassed by all of us. The empath tends to not believe in individualized emotions, as in emotions that are just mine, or that nobody else feels, or that nobody else can understand. The empath sees emotions as something we can all understand and share and feel together. This makes an empath, one, a natural scientist, and two, it makes an empath a healer. As an empath, you will struggle to have boundaries between your own emotions and other people's emotions, your own process and other people's process. You will struggle to know the difference between what another person is feeling and what you are feeling. And because of this, you are a healer in the sense that you process and you experience and you deal with the collective human trauma, the collective human issue, the issue of being human, the issue of feeling shame, the issue of feeling various deep issues. And you process and you deal with these emotions in other people, in help, through helping other people, through engaging yourself in social causes, through involving yourself with others. Typically, an empath will be driven to help other people, sometimes even before helping themselves. Doing things for others, throwing themselves into other people's issues and lives, and giving of themselves to others. Beyond that, you will be a natural scientist in the sense that you will have an innate grasp of how language and mathematics and all issues human work. You will just feel how things are supposed to be. You will have a feeling of how things should be written, how things should be spelled, how things should be said. And you don't learn in the traditional sense by observing from a true or false perspective, from a logical perspective, what is right and wrong. And this is both a plus and a minus at school, because at some points you will struggle to deal with this system of society that thinks that there are only truths and false. The natural scientist tends to think more in a gray scale,
where everything is truth-ish and false-ish. And sometimes teachers won't be able to grade that. Teachers will struggle to tell you the formal laws to solve problems, laws that you usually just have to attune yourself and meditate yourself to understand. You often don't understand grammar or issues that are more formal, but you are able to intuitively know the right answer from the wrong one. Now let's talk about some empath issues, starting with number one, natural scientist dilemmas. An empath can struggle with the question of if they are stupid, in a sense that often school and teachers and parents will feel frustrated with you for not learning fast enough, not learning the rules, not learning how to talk, not learning grammar, not learning how to write properly. And you will also struggle beyond that with how overwhelming nature can be to be in. Typically, an empath doesn't learn the traditional way. So how do they learn? Well, they learn through reading fiction, from observing people, from reflecting on and meditating on life, from naturally just letting themselves feel the way to the right answer, from skipping over the rule book and to going straight to experience, to hands-on experience of nature, to hands-on the feeling towards the right answer. But there is another issue with being an empath, and that is teaching other people how you got the answer you got, explaining your reasoning process to others, making other people understand how it is you understand nature, how it is you understand them, how you got the right answer. And that can build up to a natural frustration I've seen in so many empaths. The frustration that nobody is able to get what I get. Why don't they get it? Why don't they understand what I understand so easily? Issue number two for an empath is asking other people for help. It's the feeling that other people don't help me. Sometimes this issue comes from the fact that other people don't naturally get what you get. Because you expect other people to understand what you are experiencing and what you are struggling with without having to explain it to them. You might feel that other people are just ignoring you or that other people simply don't care about you, that they know somehow what it is you're feeling that you've never shared with them, and that they are intentionally refusing to help you. But often this is not the case. Often other people don't help you simply because you didn't ask them to. And here is the vital practice for all healer types. First, before you help other people, ask them if they want your help. Second, before you feel bad about other people not helping you, ask them if they want to help you. As an empath, take off the navigation equipment other people give you. Throw out the rule books other people give you. And do like Luke did before he shot and blew up the Death Star. Take off the helmet and trust your gut. Learn to trust your gut. Learn to trust your natural ability, your natural attunement to the universe. And it might sound freaky and spiritual, but it's not. It's simply your biological, pre-programmed, unconscious understanding of the things that you have observed. It's your ability to fill in and read in what is missing from the picture around you. It is your ability to feel and sense how the world works. And if there are two other additional advices I want to offer towards empaths, it's don't get too attached to each individual person you encounter. Don't get too attached to each individual fate that you observe. Don't get too attached to people that haven't asked for your help, that haven't asked for and don't need your personal help. Remember that just because you care about everyone doesn't mean that you have to help everyone. Remember and stay committed to some idea of collective good or of universal good. And as a natural scientist, don't be afraid to mix between your passion for the arts and for poetry and for language and for science. Don't be afraid to mix between a variety of subjects, and don't be afraid that your particular field of passion doesn't exist as a formal academic science. Don't be afraid that the topic you are interested in isn't regulated by formal academic rules. Practice a kind of universal understanding of nature without boundaries. Be a doctor that understands the human body as if it was poetry. Be a singer that sings about mathematics and about philosophy. Be an artist that draws up the most complex physics and the most complex mathematical equations known to humanity. Typically, if you combine the empath description with the MBTI description, the empath is an introverted and feeling type, as in an IXFX type. But the empath is also an feeling and a judging type, an XXFJ type, meaning the empath is an IXFJ. If you compare the four NF Myers-Briggs types, the four NFs can be divided into the idealists, who see the world through optimistic or pessimistic ideas about people, what people can be, what people can become, what people have the potential of, or the natural scientist that sees and understands people as is, as they are, as from what they feel, from what they show, from who they appear to be. NFs can also traditionally be divided into helpers and individualists, where the individualists are the ones that look out for the ordinary person, the average Joe, the normal person, who tells the stories of the people, the individual fates they encounter. And the helper, who is interested in helping collective interests to further humanity, to further the collective group and their collective group interests. So in particular, there is the empath, which is typically the INFJ, the healer, which is a natural scientist and an individualist, INFP, the champion, which is an idealist and an individualist who sees the best in the individual person, the ENFJ, who is the activist, which is the helper who looks out for the group and for the collective human interests and human rights, and the idealist that looks out for the best in people, who guards people's ideals and people's passions, and who looks at people from an optimistic point of view. And here are some misconceptions about empaths. First, that empaths always see the best in other people. No, empaths see people as they are, from a realistic point of view. This is also why empaths are said to be good for identifying psychopaths and sociopaths. Beyond this, the empath is not the healer type in the sense that they take their time to be the individual therapists of the individual person. That role is typically more dominated by other types such as INFPs and INTJ. Typically, INFJs and ENFJs are more preoccupied with healing the overall group, with balancing group interests, with healing wounds and conflicts, and for mediating between issues between different groups in a civilization. And here's the thing, yes, an empath at their worst takes the form of a form of energy vampire, in the sense that they take form of... Now, the common issue of the helper types is that they are prone to martyrdom. When other people don't help them, often they begin to overcompensate by going even more out of their way to help other people, doing even more for others, pushing their help on people who don't want it, and burning themselves up in the process of helping other people, all with one cause, to make other people feel guilty, to suck their energy, to make their energy their own. And in that sense, the empath has issues with being a form of energy vampire. Just as the champion type, the ENFP, sometimes struggles with going on vendettas towards other people, to crush them or to stomp them out or to execute some form of justice, some kind of personal brand of justice on others. And the INFP, when unhealthy, may feel that it's right to commit a wrong, to undo a past wrong. The INFP, when unhealthy, may believe that the only way to heal is to hurt. And finally, the unhealthy ENFJ may become highly demoralized by the people around them and may become, instead of champions of justice or of the best interests, the best collective interests and the people's potential, they go on a form of angry vendetta towards the community to make the community feel guilty and ashamed of themselves for what they have done. And note that all of these issues can happen to any one of us when we are unhealthy. We can all be prone to this, particularly when we are teenagers and when we are just exploring ourselves. And the goal of this video is simply to put the empath in a neutral context, to show what it is without bias, to study the lists and the definitions of empaths given on the internet, and to present the neutral definition of what the empath appears to be. Perhaps I got it wrong in this video, but I did my best to put it in a context where it can be understood without making it seem like it is something spiritual or outerworldly. I think the empath just has a unique way to feel and experience empathy and to relate to other people. A way that creates both challenges and advantages for the empath, but also a definition that gives increased value to other ways of being empathic without being an empath. A way to glorify, to show the value of being an idealist or being a healer or being a form of activist for other people.